Thank you.
Now, V, we've known each other for quite some time.
Mm-hmm.
I remember the first time I saw you, 1995, when we were in kindergarten,
mm-hmm.
and you were performing at 88's.
Right.
And I knew, sitting in the audience, like, I want to work with this person.
And we did.
And we did. Remember this?
Oh, my God. That's us at the Cowgirl Hall of Fame. We were drinking a lot in those days.
Yeah, you introduced me to whiskey and ginger ale, and my life has never been better.
Isn't that wonderful?
I absolutely love it. Tell me about the road from Cowgirl Hall of Fame to sold-out shows at Carnegie Hall.
Well, at that time, I was in this act called Kiki and Herb, and we went to Off-Broadway, and I did that for about 6 months, and I said, I'm never doing this again. I don't want to do it. And these producers said, well, what could entice you? And I said, well, I might do concerts. And they said, well, where would you want to do a concert? And I really didn't want to do it at all, so I said, Carnegie Hall. And they said, well, if we can arrange that, you would do it? I said, I guess so. And then thinking they would never, ever pull it together and we would never play Carnegie Hall. And about 7 months later, we were doing it. And I was still, at that point, I was so over playing Kiki that I almost didn't do Carnegie Hall.
That is the most beautiful story. Like, I don't know if I want to do Carnegie Hall.
Well, I sort of wanted to do it the way I wanted to do it, and that wasn't the way I wanted to do it.
Oh, okay.
But when I did it, it was worth it.
I'm sure it was.
I wasn't going to waste it on being nervous. I was just going to go out there and, you know,
live it.
I loved it. It was so great.
That's amazing. I get that feeling every Sunday at Barracuda.
At least in the bathroom.
Usually. I have some amazing memories of us trolling around the bars at 4 a.m. in the 1990s. What is your all-time favorite memory of the cock?
We did this party called Foxy, and people would do things for Foxy dollars. So there was this one queen who would put things up her butt. And one year at Christmas, Krylon, and she came out and she had this bunting wrapped around her, and she turned around and bent over and had a Christmas tree shoved up her butt and had the audience decorate it. It was beautiful.
No!
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
I didn't Google the name of your CD, Dentrophile. I did not Google it because I wanted to hear it from your mouth. What the hell is dentrophile?
A dendrophile is a person who gets an erotic charge out of nature.
Really?
Yes, like literally a tree hugger. I was on this mountain in Tennessee, and there was this big log that had fallen across this ravine, and it was covered with moss, and it was warm, you know? And so I went out and just sat on that log and started writing, and that's where I wrote most of my songs.
You really wrote these songs on dentrophile, right?
Yes, well,
that's
most
amazing.
Of them.
It's so impressive. I'm very impressed.
Thanks.
Where can we get dentrophile?
Dentrophile, you can get it on my website or justinbond.com.
Justinbond.com.
Or you can get it on iTunes.
On iTunes.
Or in, you know, a lot of stores too.
And you have a book, Tango.
And I have a book, Tango, My Childhood, Backwards and in High Heels.
I have got to read
which
that.
Is about my life in Maryland,
Maryland.
When
we
I was
have,
a
we
kid.
We have that in common. We're both from Maryland.
We're both Maryland girls, done good.
I'm so honored that you were here as our first guest.
Thank you. I'm
Thank
so
you
honored
so much,
to be
baby.
Here. It's so exciting.
I love you.
Love you.
Justin Vivian Bond.